from Iowa Robot Fighting. So as we announced earlier, we are moving from the idea of hosting events to actually competing in regional competitions. So to that end, we have started designing and testing our robots. The basic design of my personal robot is going to be a high-energy top spinner with a sloped body. This should help us to reach down to lower targets, but also defend against any grabbing robots that try for a control technique. We're 3D printing the weapon for some of the local competitions that require it, and in this video, you will see some of the testing that we've gone through. As you may have seen from some of our previous videos, we've tested several different chassis and electronic schemes to ensure that we know how to drive them forwards, but results varied, as you may have seen. So as we move forwards, we know how to design the basic systems, and we now know that we cannot do absolute direct drive. With this basic knowledge, we've moved on to designing and testing weapons. Early on, we decided it was a good idea to invest in a testing rig and box with polycarbonate windows that are able to withstand the impact of a 22 caliber rifle in order to ensure our safety while testing. This test box also allows for capture of imagery from all angles via the viewports that we've installed in the sides with polycarbonate shielding. So let's move on to the weapon tests. The initial spin-up of the first test weapon went off without a hitch. We saw no major vibrations or issues with the weapon. However, it was moving a little bit slower for the spin-up than we actually wanted. After the initial spin-up test, we moved on to an impact test using a test block with a 10% infill for 3D printed materials. And it also performed relatively well. However, the low speed of the weapon caused a bit of an issue with sticking. We then decided to follow up that test with a 30% infill block test with similar results. The 30% infill did, however, hold up slightly better than the 10% with slightly less penetration of the bolt. Because the bolt was sticking on impact, we decided that the velocity of the weapon was too low. So to remedy this, we attempted to increase the voltage being fed to the motor. However, the weapon was incapable of sustaining this level of RPM for any specific amount of time because of either print failure or damage as a result of earlier testing. The next follow-up tests will include a much larger motor with greater amounts of torque and different types of materials for the weapon type. Also, it will include a much improved 3D printed weapon.